Never be forgotten the sign of the Holy Spirit. Peace be with you. The prophet celebrated the sacred mystery one day. Let us now call to mind our sins and ask God for mercy and forgiveness for our sins.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Hear the parable of the sower. The seed sown on the path is the one who hears the word of the kingdom without understanding it. And the evil one comes and steals away what was sown in his heart. The seed sown on rocky ground is the one who hears the word and receives it at once with joy. But he has no root and lasts only for a time. When some tribulation or persecution comes because of the word, he immediately falls away. The seed sown among thorns is the one who hears the word, but then worldly anxiety and the lure of riches choke the word, and it bears no fruit. But the seed sown on rich soil is the one who hears the word and understands it, who indeed bears fruit and yields 100, 60, or 30-fold. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus.
We're all very familiar with seeds, and perhaps if you're a gardener, a vegetable gardener, or a flower gardener, or some other kind of gardener, you know that not every seed that you put in the ground is going to come up, and even the ones that do come up, there's no guarantee that you're going to get a flower, or you're going to get a tomato, or whatever you're trying to grow, right? Because we know that from our own experience. And there's not much we can do about that, right? We'll just accept that, and perhaps we'll plant more and hope that we'll get the harvest that we have hoped for. But the seed is another one of God's great miracles that he gives us, because not even scientists really can explain. You know, they can tell you about this, but they really don't fully understand this mystery of what happens with the seed. If you think about it, a seed has a very hard shell, and inside that seed is everything it needs. In fact, there's like a miniature replica of the plant or whatever it's going to grow up to be, all inside there. And it's got all the stuff, the nutrition that it needs as well. So all is one little seed. So Jesus calls us seeds. And you could say, wow. Seed? Well, we have all inside of us everything we need, right? And that God was like all inside of us, and we are replicas made in the image of Jesus. Right? But what happens after that? We have a lot to do with, we know that, right? So, and how, you know, we have to consciously make a decision every moment of our life to stay on the fertile ground. So I don't know about you, if you were picking on the vegetable gardeners, because that's where my greatest experience is. And this year, I mean, I planted two zucchini plants, and I'm growing zucchini. I could probably open a farm stand outside with so many zucchini. And the ground was fertile, right? For the water to produce these zucchinis that are growing, so it grows so fast I can't pick them size. They get too big. So think about that. We have to plant ourselves in fertile ground. So coming to Mass, that's the fertile ground, right? So we get to be nourished by the body and blood of our Lord and His Word, right? We listen to the Word and receive in the Eucharist. So that's the nourishment that helps us, and that's the fertile ground. But we know this is not just it takes effort, hard work, because there's a lot of ground out there that we should have nothing to do with, right? You just turn the television on or open a newspaper, or if you buy a newspaper, whatever you do, to stay away or recognize, well, that's not fertile ground. I'm not going to grow there. That's not where Jesus wants me to grow. And it's not going to be nourishing for me, right? So I have to avoid those people, those places, those things that might lead me into temptation, that might cause me to sin, that might be one of these seeds that didn't do too well in the gospel for the different reasons that Jesus described. So this is our challenge that Jesus is giving us, but it's a challenge that he says, I am with you to help you to spiritually grow, and I will guide you and I will lead you in that direction. To help, I will nourish you, I will support you, I will give you the grace you need to be the person that I've created you to be the best person that I've created you to be. So we open our hearts, our thoughts, and our words to Jesus this day, and we ask him to make us, enable us to be an instrument of who he created us to be.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. In the similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Also, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take it, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have kept us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that the taking of the body and blood of Christ will be entered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the feelings of charity together with Christ's uncle, Joseph, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, God, we pray. God, the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, blessed Saint Joseph, and as well, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be called to eternal life. We pray that we will pray to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, Let us pray. Graciously we present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those who have been born with heavenly mysteries to pass from formalities to newness of life through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Thanks be to God. Have a good day.
Excuse me.
Hi, how you doing?